endeavor. A special good morning to you today, Julie.
Good morning, Shannon. And that was a beautiful song from the kids' show for my son. Thank you. This is the 40th anniversary of Apollo 7. How cool.
This is Mission Control Houston. Today's wake-up music for the joint crew on board the orbiting outpost was the theme from the 1960s television series Thunderbirds by composer Barry Gray. It was played up for Canadian Space Agency astronaut Julie Payette, who noted that it's quite cool that today is the 40th anniversary of the Apollo 11 mission to the moon.
You can see here the spare parts that today's spacewalkers will be concentrating on for the first half of their spacewalk. In particular, you can make out the satellite dish of the space-to-ground antenna that they'll be working with to get it removed from the cargo carrier that it was bolted down to for the space shuttle's launch, and then into a storage area on the space station's truss. Spacewalkers beginning to move from the equipment lock of the Quest airlock into the crew lock. The difference between those two portions is that the equipment lock is where everything is stored and where the spacewalkers get into their spacesuits. The crew lock is what they'll actually work from as they go outside the space station. The hatch between the two is closed, and the crew lock is actually what's depressurized before the spacewalkers are able to switch their spacesuits to battery and officially begin the spacewalk for the day. Today's spacewalk will be the 127th spacewalk for International Space Station Assembly and Maintenance. And since we are celebrating the 40th anniversary of the Apollo 11 moonwalk today, it's also appropriate to note that it's actually the 202nd spacewalk that United States astronauts have participated in since that famous moonwalk. Also be the first spacewalk for Mission Specialist Tom Marshburn, and again the sixth for Dave Wolf, who is currently up to 31 hours and 51 minutes spent outside in space. This video shows you the end effector of the space station's robotic arm, which Mission Specialist Dave Wolf will be climbing into soon after he exits the airlock of the space station. That should be coming up pretty soon. The station's down to about 1.4 pounds per square inch, so they have a few more steps to go before they do turn their suits on to battery power, but it's not long now. That's Mission Specialist Tom Marshburn. You can differentiate the two spacewalkers once they both get out of the airlock by the dashed red stripes on Marshburn's spacesuit and the solid red stripes on Wolf's.
Can you include a look at his IRCA? We don't have a picture from Tom's helmet.
Lights off.
Lights off?
And right side, yeah. A little lower, a little outboard. That's it. Lights on.
Thanks, we got it.
Good. My lights aren't on. A little dark out that way.
You can just make out Mission Specialist Tom Marshburn in this view from Dave Wolf's helmet camera. Again, as you can see, he's wearing the dashed red stripes, while Wolf will be wearing solid red stripes on his spacesuit. And here's our first view from Mission Specialist Tom Marshburn's helmet camera. Again, you can see the small 18 in the bottom left right-hand corner that will differentiate his view from Wolf's, which has a 16 in the corner. Spacewalkers being asked to pause before they head to their first task so that Dave Wolf can turn down the cloth on Mission Specialist Tom Marshburn's spacesuit to cover some sizing rings on the ankle area of his spacesuit that's not quite covered. And although that wouldn't really be a safety problem, the metal can get hot or cold as the spacewalkers go through the day and night cycles, and it might be uncomfortable. The cloth is a thermal protection that would help keep that from happening. This view from Wolf's helmet camera as he does just that, tucking the material over the metal.
Yeah, it's the EVA folks. They're on top of it.
I'm verifying at least the two and threes are locked. I can't see the ones from here. Surprisingly, they're locked. Well, Tom, just let yourself, your head is on your right, let yourself yaw left so I can get behind you. But close your, let yourself yaw.
With that quick housekeeping item, the spacewalkers are split up now and head to a couple of different areas of the space station. Wolf will be getting onto the station's robotic arm so that he can be ready to begin the transfer of those spare parts from the cargo carrier that they were brought up in to the external stowage platform 3 on the port segment of the station's truss. Marshburn, meanwhile, is going to head that way eventually, but first he's going to move to the starboard ESP, or external stowage platform 2, to pick up a grapple bar that he'll later install on an ammonia tank assembly to get ready for the next shuttle mission to come to the space station that will be removing that ammonia tank assembly. Wolf did some work on that himself during the first spacewalk of the mission, where he removed the bolts in the area that the grapple bar is going to be installed. You hear from Marshburn's helmet camera as he's removing one of those four bolts using a pistol grip tool, which is similar to an electric screwdriver that you might use at home.
Who's going to be the other side?
Say again, turn on bolt 4.
11.
11, copy. And are you getting a red light low torque message?
I am, thank you.
Out of curiosity, what is the torque reading?
6.6.